Hi, my friends. Welcome back. Miss Turner here. Welcome to another week of art. I hope that you completed your work online from last week. And this week we're doing something a little bit different. So let me share my screen. And I need to move this thing over. Maybe that'll help. Okay. Here. All right. Welcome. This is the week of September 7th. And this week, these are I can statements for this week. And it says, I can create art using the shape of a circle and pattern. I can create an original work of art inspired by International Dot Day, which is a collaborative work of art day. Now we're going to talk a little bit more about that after we finish listening to the book, The Dot. Okay, so what will we do today? We're going to review the rules and expectations. I've already mentioned the book, and that's by Peter H. Reynolds. I'm going to introduce the use of a shape and pattern in art, and a quick little demonstration before you complete your assignment. Okay, let me pull this up. All right, now, review of rules and expectations. If you haven't heard me already say it, this art room rules poster hangs in my classroom, but it also applies to any work that you're doing from home, okay? Attitude is a choice. You need to be positive, have a positive attitude about doing your work. Respect everyone, including Miss Turner, me, because I want you to complete your work for me. And if you have any questions, I want you to feel good about giving me a call or emailing me, okay? And next is try your best, because I know some of you will say, I don't like drawing, I don't like painting, and I'm not very good at it, but you need to try. Okay, so far as expectations of this class, you should don't forget to view the video and complete the assignment. Submit your assignment to me via ClassDojo, Google Classroom, or email, and there's my email address. And offline learners, if you can turn in your art to the school when you get new flash drives. So in other words, you finish your artwork and it's time to get a new flash drive. Your mom, your dad, or whoever is picking up that new flash drive will bring the old flash drive and return the flash drive along with your artwork, okay? Okay, this is our little video, and bear with me. I hope the sound works okay. Oh, man. No, I didn't want to go that far. I'm sorry. That's what happens when you jump ahead. I've already jumped to the end. My goodness. Okay, let's try this one more time. The dot.
Art class was over, but Vashti sat glued to her chair. The paper was empty. Vashti's teacher leaned over the blank paper. Ah, a polar bear in a snowstorm, she said. Very funny, said Vashti. I just can't draw. Her teacher smiled. Just make a mark and see where it takes you. Vashti grabbed a marker and gave the paper a good, strong jab. There! Her teacher picked up the paper and studied it carefully. She pushed the paper toward Vashti and quietly said, Now, sign it. Vashti thought for a moment. Well, maybe I can't draw, but I can sign my name. The next week, when Vashti walked into art class, she was surprised to see what was hanging above her teacher's desk. It was the little dot she had drawn. Her dot! All framed in swirly gold. Ha! I can make a better dot than that! She opened her never-before-used set of watercolors and set to work. A red dot, a purple dot, a yellow dot, a blue dot. Vashti painted and painted. The blue mixed with the yellow, and she discovered that she could make a green dot. Vashti kept experimenting, lots of little dots in many colors. If I can make little dots, I bet I can make big dots too. Vashti splashed her colors with a bigger brush on bigger paper to make bigger dots. Vashti even made a dot by not painting a dot. At the school art show a few weeks later, Vashti's many dots made quite a splash. Vashti noticed a little boy gazing up at her. "You're a really great artist. I wish I could draw," he said. "I bet you can," said Vashti. "Me? No, not me. I can't draw a straight line with a ruler." Vashti smiled. She handed the boy a blank sheet of paper. "Show me." The boy's pencil shook as he drew his line. Vashti stared at the boy's squiggle, and then she said, "Sign it." The end.
Okay. That's a really great book. I really like that one. You'll notice that Vashti was kind of discouraged and needed to have a positive attitude and needed to respect her teacher, which she ended up doing those two things and trying her best. And in turn, she was able to help another student gain some confidence and create art also. Okay, quick review. What is line? Line is one of the elements of art. Elements of art are those little ingredients that make up art. Line is a path that starts with a point or a dot and continues. And we looked at different types of line, and here's some of them right here. Let me back out of this, back to my screen here. Okay, what is shape? Shape is the outline of an object. Shape is an element of art. And principles of design works together with the ingredients and elements of art. So in other words, you need to have the elements of art and principles of design enhance things about your art. And here are the principles of design: balance, unity, variety, proportion, emphasis, pattern, and movement. And we're going to focus on pattern today. Pattern can be a repetition of a shape, color, line, or symbol that's repeated. And we see that happening down here at the bottom. And let me pull it up a little bit. Okay. Lines can be repeated, and you saw that in some of your own artwork. You created patterns last week. Objects like the soccer ball has a pattern on it, and you can repeat a shape like triangle, circle, triangle, circle. Okay. An artist that I wanted us to look at is Kandinsky. Now, Kandinsky, he created abstract works of art, which means that doesn't necessarily look like a photograph. And in this series, he used the circle in different ways. He created a pattern here by doing a series of different circles over and over again. Each one of them is different, but when they're put all together, they form a larger piece of art. That's what we're talking about when we're collaborating. Each one of you will complete some type of artwork that involves a circle or a dot. And that dot will be added to a large piece of work. So even though you're not sitting side by side in a classroom, this is one way that you will work together to create a work of art. Okay, the center one is a little bit different. The color in the background is black and gray, and then he's got these vibrant little colors from the circles, and they're all different sizes, large, medium, small. It almost reminds me of like planets out of space. And here's another one. He's done basically the same thing, but there's the absence of the black in the background, and instead you've got this black border, a circle, and the use of line. Now, what I'm going to do is show you like a really quick video, a demo here on the side. But I want you to remember when you're doing your artwork to use a circle in your art. Your art does not have to look like mine or what I'm showing you in the video. These are just examples. And you may use whatever you have at home, crayon, marker, paint, whatever's around the house. Okay, let me see if I can get this. Open up. All right. Okay, there I am. First thing, you might want to use a paper plate. This is the type of paper plate I had around the house. Not all of them have this border around it, but I use this paper plate to create a work of art, and I'll show you that. Or you can use a sheet of paper, any type of paper, and trace circles or draw circles, incorporating circles. Here's one idea, and I used marker and I used crayon, and you got to watch the surface because this is a shiny surface, but it does give it a texture, which I kind of liked. You'll notice that I've got circle within circle, and I've got like circles within circles, and I also decorated the border as well. So you can, like, if you want to draw something on the edge here, you could. It's up to you. Now, if you didn't have crayon or marker, there's another way you could do this. If it will load, you pause it for a second. Sometimes that helps. You can use things like pennies or buttons and create a pattern using that. And then take a picture of it. I haven't finished, but that gives you some idea of what you might be able to do. You could also, like I said, draw. You can trace. Some of you like to do like the, maybe a face inside, like a sun with the rays. Here's something a friend did that I purchased. Here's a big one. I wanted to show you this because they used different types of pattern painted on a huge wooden disc. Now, you don't have to go out and get something this large, but I wanted to give you some idea about things you can do with a circle. So remember, you don't have to do just a pattern of circles because your artwork is going to become part of a pattern collaborative piece. Okay? Or you can just draw a series of circles, kind of like we saw in Kandinsky's work. And I traced some, I free drew some of these, so they don't have to be traced. But that gives you some idea of what you can do. Okay? Now, so International Dot Day is September 15th. So I expect you to turn in your work before then. Give me some time to do it, to put all this together. I need you to turn in your artwork as you do it. So you're creating a work of art using a circle. Online learners, you need to take a picture, post to ClassDojo, put in Google Classroom, or email me. Offline learners, remember you're turning in your work when your parents or whoever is coming to pick up a new flash drive, okay? And if you have any questions, you can feel free to email me or call me at this number. Let's see if that'll work. 563-2238. Okay, so create an original work of art using supplies from home using a circle in your design. Okay, so you've got work to do, and I hope that you enjoy creating the art and working together for International Dot Day. I can't wait to see everybody's work put together. Okay, so have a great week. I love you. I miss you. I can't wait to see your art. And take care. Bye-bye.